and welcome to the episode 7 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today, we're going to cover the events of the 7th of January. In 1961, the Beatles, with Pete Best on drums, had two evening commitments in a row. For the first, the lads performed for the first time at the Aintree Institute in Liverpool, a venue in which they would return for another 31 occasions, the last being on the 27th of January 1962. The venue was famous for two reasons. It was close from the celebrated Aintree racecourse, and its regulars liked to throw chairs at seemingly everything. Other pieces of furniture, audience, and sometimes even at the band performing. Demolished in 2007, the venue was a popular jive club in the early 1960s. The second concert was at Lantham Hall in Liverpool, a venue that hosted the first booking of the Silver Beats on the 14th of May 1960. On the 7th of January 1962, the Beatles, featuring Pete Best on drums, performed at the Casbah Coffee Club in Liverpool. The venue was owned by Best's mother, Mona, and it was one of the places in which the band performed the most often in the 1959 to 1962 period. Busy day in 1964. Between 2:30 and 4 p.m., the Beatles were at the Playhouse Theatre in London, recording a music session for the BBC radio programme Saturday Club. They taped All My Loving, Money, That's What I Want, The Hippie Hippie Shake, I Want to Hold Your Hand, Roll Over Beethoven, Johnny Be Good, and I Want to Be Your Man. The show was aired on the 15th of February between 10 a.m. and 12 noon, and it also featured a recording of I Want to Hold Your Hand that the band had recorded on the 17th of December 1963. At night, the Beatles performed two shows for the 12th evening of The Beatles Christmas Special at the Astoria Cinema, London. It was also the 12th evening of the 1965 Another Beatles Christmas Show production at the Hammersmith Odeon Cinema in London. The Beatles, as usual, performed two comedy sketches and 11 songs closing each of the two performances. On the 7th of January 1968, George Harrison flew to Bombay, India, to complete his work on his solo soundtrack for the Wonderwall feature film, recording local musicians. Finally, in 1969, the Beatles were at the Twickenham Film Studios for the fourth day of rehearsals for the Get Back TV special and the filming thereof. The highlights of the day were a new Lennon composition, Give Me Some Truth, later released on the Imagine solo album, and the rehearsal of several songs in an almost complete form. I've Got a Feeling and Don't Let Me Down, which the band performed over and over, fixing their structures, with an eye to including them in the song list of the concert. One After 909, sounding almost exactly as its final form, but obviously without the electric piano, and Maxwell Silver Hammer, in a good state of completion, but marred by the obvious disinterest of everyone but Paul McCartney. Other songs tried out today, still in the early stages of development, were Golden Slumbers, She Came In Through the Bathroom Window, and Get Back. The latter, initially, was a protest song against the anti-immigrant stance of British politician Enoch Powell and his followers, with the lyrics paradoxically exposing that racist line of thought. Soon, though, the lyrics verged away from the parody of these positions, maybe because the Beatles never treated political subjects so openly, but probably also because McCartney or someone else in the band feared someone could misunderstand the parodist element of the lyrics and think that the Beatles were actually advocating racial separation and forced repatriation of immigrants to their Commonwealth countries. This version of the lyrics is known between Beatles fans as the No Pakistanis version. The session included the usual mix of random jams and performances of oldies and covers, with rock and roll music, Gone Gone Gone, Lucille, and What Did I Say, tried out with most conviction by the four. Well, I guess that's all for today. Short and sweet, I suppose. But then again, this is a show focused on facts and actions, and if the Fab Four didn't do a lot of interesting things in a given day, the episode has to reflect that. Once again, it's time to remind you to please check www.simonmas.com/support to find ways to support these podcasts, me, and my other music-related projects. The episode description has both a complete list of songs recorded during the Get Back sessions and an Amazon affiliate link should you want to buy the sources I've used to write this and other episodes. Remember that this won't cost you a penny. Whatever money I get, I will receive from Amazon's slice of the earnings. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.